Rockingham County High School, are you ready? Your time starts now.
Pupils' voices, conning over their lessons, might be heard of a drowsy summer's day, like the hum of a beehive, interrupted now and again by the authoritative voice of the master.
Children, I'll remind you, undutiful children, are cursed by God. There's a secret blast of God upon undutiful children. And the fangs of darkness shall be the ravens and eagles that shall fasten their talons in the eyes of those children, so that there be no sullenness, no sauciness, no rude retorting in your deportment, in which these scholars are waste weep to seek the conscience of God. Don't set light by this, good master, and hearken to him, and do the task which he imposes upon you. Love thy schoolmaster, and prize him. Be thankful to him. Be thankful to God for him. These are ways to escape the curses of God. Now, have your books open. Repeat after me. So go me see do.
So go me see do.
Ichabod Crane was not, in truth, one of those cruel potentates of the school. On the contrary, he administered justice with discrimination rather than severity.
I go.
Taking the burden off the backs of the weak and laying on those with strong.
See me.
The little puny thing that winces at the least forged part of the rod was passed by with an indulgence.
See me go so.
But the claims of justice were satisfied by inflicting a double portion on some little, tough, wrong-headed urchin.
See me do so.
Always remember, children, certain it is, I'm doing my duty by thy parents.
And the school was dismissed. The revenue arising from his schoolhouse was small,
and would have been scarcely sufficient to furnish him with daily bread.
But he was a huge feeder.
And though lank, he had the dilating powers of an anaconda.
To help out his maintenance, he was boarded and lodged at the houses of the farmers whose children he instructed.
In his half-itinerant life, also, he was a sort of traveling gazette, carrying the budget of local gossip from house to house.
Good Master Ichabod, do tell us, please, whether or not 'tis true what we hear tell of the doctors of Air White.
We pity them, and it is owing to that heartfelt pity that we wish to know.
Certainly it is. I will say, madam, mistress, I'll say no more. It's not so. It is indeed so.
Well,
it is so. The elves.
Emmeline!
She is certainly bewitched. Having a great authority over symptoms that of a fortnight that fine, the most honorable minister of cotton matters, the most of the book, the history of New England witchcraft, the man third study, the office.
You are a man of great erudition, Schoolmaster Crane.
Pardon?
You are very knowledgeable.
Certain it is, for am I not schoolmaster, have I not read several books quite thoroughly?
Indeed, you are our jewel and admiration.
I would acknowledge the truth of your words, but pride goeth before a fall. Anyways, the eldest white girl here is possessed of a demon, with nonified circles as an agony. Yes, the very skin of her belly is stretched till it cracks.
No!
Yes, walk as she does with a mighty weight upon her.
But schoolmaster, perhaps she's
truly bewitched.
But
certain it is.
Ichabod Crane was an odd mixture of small shrewdness and simple fragility.
She has grown agony. No concealment.
His appetite for the marvelous and his powers of digesting it were equally extraordinary.
This is a demonstration of a very far towards possession of the spirit.
Wait,
no tale was too gross or too monstrous for his capacious swallow, whether they be marvelous tales of ghosts and goblins.
Goblins can most successfully be warded off by the odor of roses.
And haunted fields.
Having a great authority that barley's a witching agent.
And haunted brooks.
Beware the barbings, as their teeth are very sharp.
And haunted bridges.
Trolls, enough said.
And haunted houses.
'Tis rightful to fear the fields of man, fully infernal.
And particularly, the headless horsemen.
Ah! Where?
And though Ichabod Crane had seen many specters in his time, and had been more than once beset by Satan in diverse shapes, daylight came into these evils, and he would have passed upon his life with it, if his path had not been crossed by a being that causes more perplexity to mortal man than all the ghosts, goblins, and the whole race of witches put together, and that was a woman.
In addition to his being schoolmaster, he was also singing master of the neighborhood, and picked up many a bright shilling for fine struck young folks
On Sundays, Schoolmaster Crane took little to no vanity to take a station in front of the church gallery,
where, in his mind, he completely carried away the palm from the parson.
His voice resounded far.
Oh, so far.
Above the rest of the choir.
Master and Mistress Twiller, I trust we're all well this evening?
Yes.
Thank you. Excellent. All my musical disciples have assembled for this week's instruction. For Mistress Odie.
Katrina.
Yes, I know.
I thought I saw her walking with
Katrina Van Tassel, the only daughter of her substantial father, Mynheer Van Tassel.
We know.
That ripe, fresh 18 and rosy cheek is well known for father's peaches.
We know.
Not just known for her beauty, but for her vast expectations.
We know.
Not so safe, you know why? There she is.
Schoolmaster Crane, I do hope I'm not kept everyone waiting.
We shall always wait for you. We'd be most happy for waiting. My show of forgiveness for waiting will be my job to get that busy now.
Oh, yes. And knowing I was so often forgotten, Papa gave me a shilling for me. Here.
Keep us in front of the token of forgiveness. Now, let's get started. The Lord is my shepherd and so forth. Psalter's open, chin's up, voice raised. All righty now.
have to stop the breathing first again?
Certain it is.
In all truth, we do more breathings from our papa shilling than we do singing.
Katrina, I profess not to know how a woman's heart is moved in one. To me, they've always been a matter of really admiration. Some of which only have one point of access, while others have a thousand avenues and a thousand different ways that are won. And someone who wins a thousand common hearts saves someone now. I want to keep the undisputed sway of yours, Katrina, indeed, the hero.
Whatever do you mean, schoolmaster?
How might I win you, mistress of my heart?
Who's to say but that you've already won? You are very dear, schoolmaster. You may kiss my hand if you wish. Papa and Mama ask me to invite you to our open ball tomorrow evening. Do say you'll come. Everyone will be there. Everyone.
Not to expect, Katrina.
The next day, the gallant Ichabod spent at least an extra half hour at his toilet, cleaning up and furbishing up his vest, an indeed suit of only rusty black, and arranging his clothes by a bit of broken looking glass.
He borrowed a horse from a farmer with whom he was domiciliated.
And, thus gallantly mounted, issued forth with a knight errant in quest of adventures.
The animal was a broken down plow horse that had outlived everything but its viciousness.
Still, he must have had fire in his day, for his name was.
Happy I am, certain it is, the sky is clear and serene, and nature wears that principle of liberty which always associates the idea of abundance. And some trees have worn that silver brown and yellow, and some trees have been nipped by frost, but into brilliant dyes of purple, blue, and scarlet. Oh, the joys of jolly autumn! And those yellow pumpkins turning up their fair brown bellies to the sun, giving the ample prospects of luxurious pies, and the fragrance of the buckwheat field, and the hum of the beehive. And those dainty slapjacks, well buttered garnished by the dimpled hand of Katrina Van Tassel. It was towards evening that Ichabod arrived at the castle of Air Van Tassel.
It was thronged with the pride and the flowers of the adjacent country.
Father of the Van Tassel's mansion.
Come in. What are all the bars on this adventure? A sample charm.
A genuine Dutch country tea table.
In the sumptuous time of autumn.
Such heaped up platters of cakes.
Of almost indescribable base kind.
There was a toady donut.
And a crisp and crumbling fruller.
Sweet cake and shortcake.
Ginger cake and honey cakes.
And the whole family of cakes.
And then there were apple pies.
And peach pies.
And pumpkin pies.
Besides slices of ham and smoked beef.
And delectable dishes of preserved plums.
And peaches.
And pears.
And quinces.
Delicious.
And roasted chicken.
Together with bowls of milk and cream.
All with the motherly teapot sending a cloud of vapor from the midst.
Oh, heaven bless the table.
I want time and breath to discuss this figure as dessert.
Donkey, you air schoolmaster.
Ichabod, indeed. As some men do with drink.
Oh, to be the lord of this almost unimaginable luxury and splendor, certain it is.
They're going to play the reel.
Come in. Halt the dance.
Thank you. Fussy, etc.
I guess. No, Kessing. What's your wager, schoolmaster?
Such a sprightly time it is. Have you not heard who's been patrolling the county of late? Aye, 'tis none other.
Yes, tonight in each other's horses in the graves in the churchyard.
Dame Phyllis, though, or was it Herod Twiller?
The church is full of troubled spirits, certainly it is.
And that's the place where he's most frequently encountered, don't you know? But it's most common knowledge that if you make it to the churchyard bridge, he will not fall.
He cannot. God preserve us.
Remember old Brower?
A most heretical disbeliever in ghosts.
How we met the horseman returning from being in Sleepy Hollow and was obliged to get behind him?
How they galloped over brush and brake, hill and swamp, until they reached that bridge.
Then, suddenly, the horseman turned to a skeleton, threw a brow into the brook, and sprang away over the treetops with a clap of thunder.
Oh, the brow's got nothing on me. I've seen the thing myself.
You don't say, Brom.
I've just seen it.
Truly.
Truly. I need someone in the brook to tell me things some folks are too afraid to take in from you. You see, coming back one night from Grunsburg, I was overtaken by your own midnight sugar. There you are, guys. Wow, that gun. Right as high as a house he was. And his head were off and sailing upon a little saddle. I said to myself, what are you laughing at, your old ghost? You know what? That was true. He offered the bracelet for a bowl of punch. And I said, sure. And off we flew. And I would have wanted to, no doubt about it. Old Daredevil beat that goblin horse. And as we approached the old church bridge, he actually bolted that bash! And a flash of fire. What have you said to that, schoolmaster?
Ichabod repaid him in kind with large, very large extracts from his invaluable author, Cotton.